Assalamualaikum to all of you. Hope that you all are doing fine there. Right, for today we are going to continue with the last subtopic under sale of goods, which is under remedies for breach. So the learning outcomes for today is, at the end of the lessons, students should be able to explain the remedies that are available to both buyer and seller. Alright, basically, remedies means the rights. Okay, the rights given to the innocent party. So, under law of sale of goods, these rights can be given either to seller or buyer, depends on their performance of the contracts. For example, let's say, okay, buyer and seller enter into contract, but seller fail to deliver the goods. So here, buyer has right to take action against seller. So under law of sale of goods, we need to identify what are the kinds of remedies, okay, that are available to both of them in case if there is a breach of contract. So basically, chapter 5 and chapter 6 of the Sale of Goods Act, okay, the statute, deal with the rights of the unpaid seller against the goods. Later, you will know who is an unpaid seller. Second, rights to sue for breach of the contract. Right of the buyer to sue for damages for non-delivery. Right of the buyer to bring an action for specific performance. Remedies available to the buyer for breach of warranty and buyer's action in tort. And then, please take note as well, okay, when there is a breach by buyer, okay, these situations may happen. First, based on section 44 of the Act, failure of the buyer to take delivery of goods. When seller made delivery but buyer fail to take the delivery, and then buyer fail to accept the goods as provided in section 56 of the Act. So these remedies, okay, are very useful in case there is a breach of contract of sale. Right, first of all, we look into the rights of seller, okay, the remedies of seller. Right, for seller, the rights can be divided into two. First is rights in rem. Rights in rem means rights against the goods. And the second one is rights in personam. Rights in personam means right against personal. In this situation, right against buyer. Okay, so we start with rights in rem first. Rights of unpaid seller against the goods. First, we need to define who is an unpaid seller. You may refer to section 45 of the Act. Defines an unpaid seller is a seller to whom the whole of the price has not been paid or tendered. Let's say the seller only get half of the payments, so still considered as unpaid seller. Or when a bill of exchange or other negotiable instruments has been received as conditional payment, and the condition on which it was received has not been fulfilled due to the instrument being dishonored or for some other reasons. Okay, based on second situations, unpaid seller also can be considered as person who received the check, for example, but the check is dishonored. Okay, check too cannot be credited into his account. So there is a problem, then he still not get his payment rights, so he is considered as unpaid seller. Okay, normally for seller, he has a remedy first to sue for the price of the goods as stated in section 55 and damages for non-acceptance by the buyer as provided in section 56 of the Act. However, seller also entitled to claim additional remedies. This is so-called as rights in rem, based on section 46, subsection 1 of the Act. Okay, so there are four rights in rem, okay, particularly available to the seller. First, where he is in possession of the good. When the seller still has a possession of the goods, then he has rights of lien on the goods. Okay, liens here means rights to hold the possessions. Okay, based on section 46, subsection 1A. Second, where he has parted with the possession of the goods, then he has a right of stopping the goods in transit. In the case of the buyer, is in sovereignty. Insolvency is means when the buyer is declared as bankrupt, based on section 46, subsection 1B. And then subject to section 54, seller also has right to resell the goods under section 46, subsection 1C. And where the property in goods has not passed to the buyer, a right of withholding delivery. Okay, please bear in mind that there is a difference, right of lien and rights of withholding a delivery. Right of liens can be exercised when the ownership already passed to the buyer. But rights of withholding of delivery may be exercised when the ownership has not passed to the buyer, based on section 46, subsection 2. Okay, we proceed with the rights of lien. Right of lien. Okay, this right exists when the seller is still in a possession of the goods. Possessions means that, possession, goods tu masih ada dengan seller. Even though that ownership has passed to the buyer, based on section 46, subsection 1A of the Act. When the property in goods has not passed to the buyer, then the seller may exercise the right of a holding delivery as provided in section 46, subsection 1. Okay, so this is what I have explained to you just now. Okay, if to exercise right of liens, meaning that the goods must be in a possession of the seller, even the ownership already passed to buyer. In order to exercise right of withholding delivery to stop the delivery first, the ownership has not passed to the buyer. Unpaid seller, who still possess them is entitled to retain the position of the antepayment or tender of the price in any of the following events, as stated in section 47, subsection 1. Okay, so right of lien means that seller can hold the positions of the goods. Okay. In this situation, first, when the goods have been sold without any stipulation as to credit. In other words, goods must be sold based on cash, and then the goods have been sold on credit, but the term of credit has expired. Seller give credits to the buyer, but buyer fail to pay the goods, and the buyer becomes insolvent when the buyer becomes a bankrupt. Okay, so seller may exercise his right of lien even if he is in the possession of the good as agent or bailee for the buyer. Even he is considered as agent, he also can exercise this right based on section 47, subsection 2. If the seller has made part delivery of the goods, part delivery means that the process, to deliver the goods to the buyer, then he may exercise his right of lien on the remainder, unless the part delivery has been made under such circumstances which indicate that seller have waived the lien as provided under section 48. Okay, seller waive the lien means that seller himself ketepikan lien tu, meaning he don't want he does not want to be protected under rights of lien. Okay, however, unpaid seller may lose his lien based on section 49, subsection 1, when he delivers the goods to a carrier or other bailee in order to the goods be transmitted to the buyer without reserving the rights on disposal of the goods. Okay, when the goods already delivered to a carrier, it means that in the process of transmissions, goods is not in seller's possessions, right? So seller can exercise right of lien. Second, the buyer or his agent lawfully obtains possession of the goods when buyer already received the goods and when the seller waive his lien. Okay, next we continue with stoppage in transit. Okay, stoppage in transit here based on section 50, provided that when the buyer of goods becomes insolvent. So this is the only circumstances that allow buyer to stop the transits. Okay, and then unpaid seller has parted with the position of the goods in the process of transmissions, then the seller has the right of stopping them in transit so long as the goods are in the course of transits. Okay, so how to exercise? First, based on by taking actual position of the goods under section 52, subsection 1, or seller give notice. Okay, to the carrier in whose position the goods are, section 52, subsection 2. Okay, or seller just give a notice to the courier or carrier, okay, who has the position of the goods. Okay, so when the seller give notice of stoppage in transit to the carrier, and then carrier shall re-deliver the goods according to seller. And it will be at the seller's expense. Okay, what are the effects of stoppage in transit? This is to restore the right of position, because the carrier here, okay, send back the goods to the seller. Now seller has the positions of the goods, so seller can exercise the rights of lien until buyer make payment. However, okay, the transits ends, okay, based on these situations, section 51, subsection 1, when the buyer takes delivery from the carrier, and when the buyer obtain delivery of the goods on the arrival at the appointed destination, based on section 51, subsection 2, right? Okay, next we continue with right of seller to resale.